Good afternoon, dear students. Now, in previous lectures, we have finished chapter 2, that is Introduction to Surveying. Now, in continuation, we shall move to next topic, that is linear measurement. Up till now, we have understood definitions of surveying, what is the purpose of surveying for which we are all learning this thing. Then we also understood little bit of scale, how to make a scale on a piece of paper or rather on the drawing sheet. Now we move to actual field measurement, because whatever drawings, whatever plans we make, that is only possible if we perform field measurements. So in the coming lectures, we would be more concentrating on the field measurements. In that, the first one which we are going to discuss right now, that is linear measurement. Now, to just understand linear measurement, it is nothing else the I can say distance measurement. Now, how the distance measurement is done? When we measure the distance, it is usually required to measure the distance in horizontal plane. Whenever we have plane surveying, the distance between two points should be a horizontal distance. Suppose if we measure the distance along the slope, then our construction or our constructional activities are not going to operate on the slope distance. So what we have to do? We have to convert those slope distance or inclined distance into the horizontal distance for the preparation of plans and maps. Now, what are the methods of the distance measurement? If we go back very early period, when there were no instruments available. Now, broadly, we divide into two methods. One is direct method, another is indirect method. Direct, as name suggests, directly we are measuring the distance. Indirect method, we shall discuss little later. There are two types. One is optical methods, another would be the EDM method. Now let us discuss first this direct method. Now, as name suggests, direct methods, the distance is directly measured in the field using a chain. Chain is an instrument which we will understand little later. Tape, everybody would have seen in your daily activities, or when we want to measure the distance somewhere, suppose a length of room, we take a tape and measure with the help of tape. So the same instrument. So distance is directly measured in field using a chain or tape, and this is the most, I shall say, the most commonly used for the linear measurement, and those we will discuss in more detail here. Now, indirect method, what they will do, as name suggests, distance will not be measured directly in the field. We will take some other observations, we will take some other measurements, and then by using some formulae, we will convert those observations into the distance. And that is done in tachyometry. Tachyometer is an instrument which gives us the distance directly using some formula. So that is indirect method, or which is also in the optical method. So in optical method, that principle of optics, that is coming from the physics, we know that is used to compute the distance between two points using a special type of theodolite. Just we spoke that is tachyometer, with stereo diaphragm. Then comes electronic distance measurement, EDM, which just I have discussed that. So on what principle they relies? They relies on the propagation of waves, reflection of waves, that is the radio waves or microwaves, and they will measure the distance by bisecting the targets. Means you have instrument at your location, you will fix the target some distance away from the instruments, and then that will bisect the target with this principle, microwave or light wave or radio waves, and then it will give us the distance directly. So this optical and electro distance measurement, right now we are not going to discuss in more detail, but just for information, these are also the methods to measure the distance. Now let us discuss more details about the direct method. Now in the direct method, let us have a quick look on the approximate method. Approximate word means you are not exactly measuring the distance, but you can have an idea about the distance. Say the first one, I say pacing. Now pacing is nothing else, we walk over the ground. Initially when we suppose a task is given to us and we want to measure the distance between two point, and we do not have any instrument, so what I do is I simply walk over the ground or walk over the line and just count the pace. Pace means the distance between two legs. An average length of pace is usually between 70 to 80 centimeter, and we can take 80 centimeter. So the approximate distance between two points can be simply found out by multiplying this number of paces with the average length of pace. If you are walking and you have suppose 60 paces, so 60 into 80, around 480 4800 centimeter, or I can say 48 meter. So the distance between that which you walked over, that would be 48 meter. So this could give us an approximate idea about the distance, that pacing one. Second one, pacometer. Now this is an watch like instrument, a small instrument which counts the number of pace. So what is the advantage here? You need not to take the pain of counting. That instrument you keep in your pocket, it has a counter, and you, as you walk, the counter will start and you stop, that counter will end, and it will give you the total number of pace. But the distance we will get again by multiplying the number of pace with the average pace distance. Then pedometer. Pedometer directly gives the distance traversed by the person by multiplying the number of pace with average pace length. So further modification here, you need not to even count it and you need not to know the pace distance. So simply you pedometer, you run the pedometer over the length of line or whichever the distance you want to measure, and then it will give you the total distance. Then odometer. Now odometer is same, simple device attached to the wheel of bicycle or an automobile. It will record the number of revolution made by the wheel and calculates the distance as the product of perimeter and number of revolution. So as wheel rotates, the distance covered by wheel would be its perimeter. So number of revolutions multiplied by perimeter, that is one distance covered in one revolution, that will give you the total distance. So these were old method when the instruments were not available or we want to measure the approximate distance. But suppose, or in our case where we prepare the plan or map, or where we do the best measurement, then these approximate methods will not work. We have to have the true methods, or which will give us the accurate measurement. So now comes the chaining. This chaining is simply defined as distance measurement in the field with the help of chain or tape. Suppose you use a chain to measure the distance, so that is known as chaining. Even you use the tape to measure the distance, that is also known as chaining. There is no other word like taping. There is no such kind of word in surveying. We shall call it chaining only. So the process of measuring the distance with chain or tape, we will define as chaining. Now, chaining is considered accurate and common method of measuring the distance. Rather, tapes are more accurate and easier to carry as compared to the chain. However, we can say the chains are ideally suited for the rough use in the difficult ground, because grounds are not like a uniform ground. When we actually go to the field, the ground situations are also, they are the difficult. Sometimes it is difficult to walk over the ground. So many undulations, so many irregularities are there which we have to come across. So chaining is considered ideally suited for in that case. Now let us have a little description about the chains which we use in distance measurement. Surveying chains, the common name given to the chains, that is surveying chains. It is same as in a local language we can say the sakad. Sakad is nothing else, that is a chain. But here we use to distance measurement, so that is usually we call it chain. Now first one is the metric chain, which is most commonly used nowadays for our surveying purpose. Now how it look like? It consists of large link of galvanized mild steel wire of 4 mm diameter bent into circular shapes. This three rings are bent together, they will make a chain. Now two links are connected by three circular or oval shaped rings which provide flexibility in the handling, because handling is also an important part here. And this figure we can see here, that is showing the metric chain. Now you can see this, I can also show this here, which is like it has a handle like this, and then it is joined by one second and another third like this in this case. So it is connected by three more or less three rings. I can say this is 1 2 3 1 2 3, and from here to here, the distance from center of this ring to center of this ring, that is known as link. And it would be provided with two handles at both end. Two handles would be there, and the distance from outside of one handle to the outside of another handle would be total the length of chain. So the handle length is also included in that. We shall not count from here to here. That would be the wrong length, I shall say. It should be the end of one handle to end of another handle. That is the length of chain. Usually that is 20 meter or 30 meter. Both lengths are available in the distance measurement. So this is GI wire. GI wire, galvanized iron wire, and usually 4 mm thickness. This 4 mm thickness that bent into the circular shape and connected by one another ring, so that makes around 3 rings together. And center to center of this ring, that is one link is treated. So that is this we can also see the handles are given on the two ends, and from outside of one handle to the another handle, that is the total length of chain that is written is 20 meter. Now what extra we can know about that, the distance between the center to center of two consecutive middle links is the length of link. So that also we can see, that center of one ring to another ring, and again the center of one ring to another ring, that is a link. Now a 20 meter chain contains 100 links. So naturally this one link will come out to be 20 divided by 100. So that is 20 centimeter or 0.2 meter. So length of one link is 0.2 meter and total chain will have 100 links. So such 100, if I come here again, such 100 links are available. So whenever we have to count the length would be counted. Length would be counted by number of links. So we will count the number of links. How? Now it would be difficult to count every time the link length. Means I have to count link 1, 2, 3, 4, and then suppose the length is 15 meter. So shall I count from one link to the link up to the 15 meter length? Means 1 meter will have 5 links. So if I have to go up to 15 meter, I have to count 75 links. So that is not the good way to count or good way to reflect the distance. So what additional thing we will have, in order to read the fractional length. Fractional length means less than 20 meter. Every time not necessary your length would be 20 meter. It would be less than 20 meter. Then what arrangements are given? The small brass rings are provided at every meter. Small brass rings are provided at every meter. Then tallies are provided at every 5 meter. So at 5 meter they will have the marking. That marking is known as tallies. And over that marking, that 5 meter is written. And brass rings will not be provided where the tallies are attached, because already we have a such arrangement that it will show the 5 meter. So why to provide this small brass ring there? So brass ring would be there, that we can also see from the figure. This shows the brass ring that is at every meter. Then you can see by the side of that brass tally, that 5 meter, and 5 meter is marked over that. Then you will have the brass tally at the 10 meter. It is wrongly written here 10 centimeter. I shall say sorry for that. That is 10 meter. And then brass tally at 15 meter. And these are also the shapes defined. Means at 5 meter you will have such kind of shape. At 10 meter you will have such kind of shape. At 15 meter you will have such kind of shape. And then at every ring, this brass, at every meter, this brass ring would be available. So suppose I want to read the 15 meter, suppose I want to read this say 15 or say 16.4 meter. My length is 16.4 meter, say. Now how I will count from the chain? Now a chain is there and I want to read this 16.4 meter. Okay. So what I do, the total length is from here to here is, from this handle to this handle is 20 meter. That is the length of chain given. So how I will count? 15 meter mark, that brass tally just we have seen. So I will search for the 15 meter mark. Then you will have brass tally here and written mark 15 meter mark over that. Then what I will search? 1 meter. So what 1 meter mark I will have? That is a brass ring. That is circular in shape. This is almost brass tally like this. Like this brass tally. Just we have seen. So 15 meter over is written over here. Then brass ring, that is of at every 1 meter. So this makes 16 meter. Now further I have to have this 0.4 meter. So what I do? Two links. I count two links. How much it will make? Because one link is of 20 centimeter. So this 20 centimeter, two links will make 0.4 meter or 40 centimeter. That adding this together, I will get 16.4 meter. So I want to show that these brass tally or brass rings, which are marked at every 5 meter, 10 meter, 15 meter, and these are marked at every 1 meter, they will help us to read the fractional distance very fast. Means you need not to count from the beginning. Means I have not to go from here, see this is 5 meter mark, 10 meter mark, then 15 meter mark. So I have not to start from here, just I have to go to search where the 15 meter mark is there. So when once I get this 15 meter mark, easily after that 15 meter I can move further 1 meter, that will go to 16 meter, and I can search this brass ring there, and then two more link, that will make the total 0.4 meter. So that's what we get, the 16.4 meter. So this is about the metric chain, which we will use in more practice in nowadays in surveying. Now some further chains are also available, even when we have been measuring the distance in FPS system, that is foot pound system. One in that is Guntur chain or Gunter's chain. This is also known as surveyor's chain. Now this chain is used in earlier days. Just I spoke that FPS system and distance we all used to say in feet. We never use a meter during that days. That was the English system. So in foot pound system, it is used to find the area of land, generally in acres, because area of land was also shown in acre. Now this chain is of 66 feet length. The length of chain is 66 feet, and it also have 100 links, right? So let us see this 66 feet, how it will work. Just 66 feet, total 100 links, right? So if I have, what would be the length of one link? One link would be, that is 66 divided by 100, so 0.66 feet, that is there, right? Now if I count 10 chains of these 66 feet, so what I will get is 66 into 10, that is 660 feet. That is known as 1 furlong. Furlong is the unit which we, our ancestors, our grandfathers and our forefathers used to give the distance. They used to say, I have walked about 5 furlong. So that 5 furlong actually is 1 kilometer. So this 10 Gunter's chains, that is 660 feet. And 660 feet divided by 3, if you do approximate 3.3, you will get 200 meters. So that will make the 1 furlong. Then if I multiply this 80 Gunter's chain, then simply 8 times of 200, it will make 200 into 8, 1.6 kilometer. And 10 square Gunter's chain, that will make 1 acre. Now acre and hectare, nowadays we have area measurement more frequent in hectare. So hectare and acre, they have some relation of 2.47, means acre is further larger in measurement rather than hectare. Then we have third category, that is engineer's chain. Now this is very useful chain in the earlier periods when civil engineers were used to measure the distance. So the chain was kept like in such a manner that it was of 100 feet in length, 100 feet in length and having 100 links. So each link is of 1 foot long, very very simple. You measure one link, 1 foot. So as many number of links you will measure, and as many number of feet distance you will get. So this was a very simple one, and every 10 link a brass tag is fixed. So that at every 10 link means at a distance of 10 feet you will have a mark. Okay, this up to this brass tag you have a 10 feet distance. So also we can have 10 multiple distance in multiple of 10 each meter, each feet. Then finally the revenue chain, that is the fourth one. Now it is a 33 feet long chain containing 16 links, and length of each link is 2, and naturally if you divide 33 divided by 16, what you get is 2:1/16. So length of one link is 2:1/16 feet, and this chain is used in cadastral survey, which we discussed in the very first lecture. That is cadastral survey or public land survey, that is used to fix the boundaries of property line, boundaries of agricultural field. These all are measured with the help of revenue chain. Now testing and adjustment of chain. Now as I discussed that the length of chain is 20 meter, and it is made with the help of GI wire. So due to the continuous use of the chain, there are more chances that the length of chain gets altered. It will not remain same as 20 meter. I am using 20 meter chain and I am working with that chain for suppose number of times, so the length of chain may get altered. So that's what we need to check it time to time. Now how we will check the length? A chain is tested by comparing its length with the standard steel tape. So what just you can see in the figure that two pegs are fixed at a distance that is of 20 meter. Maybe the standard steel tape is of 20 meter. So two pegs are fixed at a distance of this one, and then that would be measured with the or compared with our chain which we are using regularly. So we have to test whether the chain which we are using is of true length, is of really 20 meter, or it has got reduced, or it has got increased due to continuous use. Why it got reduced? Suppose joints are closed up, or link got bent. One link is there, if it got bent due to use, so that will cause the reduction in length. When it will have more length than 20 meter due to opening of joints, suppose when we use the chain for distance measurement, we have to keep it that chain in the perfect horizontal position so that we have to apply a pull. So when we apply the pull, there would be more chances that joints may get opened. So by that the length of chain gets more than the 20 meter. So what remedy we will do if chain is found too long? Too long means its length is 20 meter. If it is more than 20 meter, then what we will do? So it has to be adjusted. It has to be adjusted by following measures, like we can close the opened out joints circular connecting rings. Then we can also replace the one or more circular ring with the bigger one. Then reshaping the elongated ring, whatever rings got distorted in shape. Say circular ring is converted into the oval shape, so that oval has more length than circle, so we have to take it back into the circle. So that is reshaping the elongated ring. Then replacing the damaged ring. Suppose any rings are damaged, we can replace them. So that is the chain found too long. Now there are even chances that chain is found shorter in length, means it is found shorter than the true length, that is 20 meter. So how we can correct now? We can straighten the bent links. So if links are not just I would like to explain in this also. Suppose your chain is in this pattern and this link is bent like this. You have a handle here and you have a handle here. So that is a chain which has got reduced length, means length is less than 20 meter. Length is less than 20 meter. So this is the link which has got bent. This is a bent link, right? So this bent link, what it will do? It will reduce the length. So to make it to 20 meter, we have to simply make it like this. So that will make our length very correct. That is 20 meter. One. Then second, also our this joints are opened out. Suppose this opening is more due to application of pull while straightening the chain. So what we have to close these joints. So when we close all this opened out joint, then naturally we would be able to reduce the length. Or when length is less than 20 meter, then reversibly we can open it. So little opening of joint, all the joints, it will also increase the length. So by this manner, we can even introducing additional circular ring. Suppose the length of chain is too small or too less, then we can also introduce one additional circular ring to make it to 20 meter. And some circular ring can also be flattened so as to increase the length. Now moving to next instrument for the linear measurement. Now we have just understood about the chain. Four types of chains are there which are employed to measure the distance. Out of that, one major one, that is metric chain, which is of 20 meter, usually is used in our distance or linear measurement practice. Then another chain we discuss, that is Gunter's chain or surveyor chain, we can call it engineer's chain, or fourth one is revenue chain. So these all three other chains, they are in FPS system, and nowadays we are not following such kind of system. So I shall say that metric chain is the only one which we are using quite frequently in our surveying work. Now only chain cannot serve the whole measurement purpose. It is to be assisted by tape. So let us understand what different types of tapes are employed in surveying. Now tapes are used in the case of more accurate measurement. Then we understand that tapes are made of various material. In your daily activities, in your house also, you would have at least one tape, or you would have seen at least one tape that may be made of cloth, that may be made of steel, or that may be made of some any other material. Just we discuss a little later, right? So now what are the advantage of the tape? The tapes are light in weight compared to the chain, because they are made of some metallic material or they are made of some cloth material, but they cannot withstand rough handling as chain can have. Suppose you are working in the undulating ground, then if you are straightening the tape with a quiet pull, then there are more chances that tape can break. So it cannot withstand rough handling as the chain, because chain is of steel or GI wire material. Now generally we have four types of tapes are used in the linear measurement in assistance with the chain also. Now first one is the cloth or linen tape. Now these tapes are made of varnished strip of woven linen. Linen is a textile material which is of about 12 to 15 mm wide, and they are available in length of generally 10 to 30 meter. And this is the simplest tape, I shall say, that is they are used for taking offset measurement. However, they have the limited use in surveying. Now, offset measurement means from one line, we want to take another perpendicular line. This is generally termed as offset. More detail we will understand later. But if we want to take the offset, we use cloth tape. But their use is limited. Why? Because of these factors, easily affected by moisture and get shrunk. Now, once it gets shrunk, means its length is not true as it was purchased or as it was kept in the laboratory. It is reduced, so it will give the erroneous reading. Then length of tape gets changed due to stretching also. One is shrunk, so shrunk means reduction in length, but after the continuous use of stretching, the length of tape gets changed. And it is likely to twist during a strong wind. When you are working in the open field or in the ground, at the ground, and suppose winds are blowing, then it is very difficult to handle that tape in a perfect position rather than the chain. Now, second one is the metallic tapes. They are made of waterproof fabric interwoven with the thin wires of the brass, bronze or copper. Now, previously we have seen the cloth tape. It has only the cloth material. But now the strength is given to the cloth by using these thin wires of brass, bronze or copper. So it will give little strength to them. So that is also written. This metal wire provides reinforcement to the fabric. That fabric is maybe the cloth or some other composition, and prevent stretching. So when we stretch it, it will not get affected in terms of length. So all the disadvantages of cloth tape, generally they are overcome or they are removed or eliminated. Now, that is, width of tape is usually same that was of the cloth one, and length is also available in various length, maybe 10 meter, 20 meter, even 30 and 40 or 50 meter. Now, this picture you can see metallic tape, some part of tape is out, which you can see some markings over that, and remaining part is inside. So, and this is very common thing, and you have another arrangement you can see at the bottom, which can fold, which is used to fold the tape when it is open or when it is out. Now, steel tape, as the name suggests, it would be made of material steel. Now, that is stainless steel, and this is more preferable compared to the earlier two previous type of tapes, because it does not get varied in length due to the temperature or due to some other pull application. So they are available in length of 10 meter to 50 meter now, but the main thing is that steel tapes are more costlier compared to the cloth and metallic tape, but they are giving very accurate distance measurement to us. Now, tape is generally graduated and numbered in meter, decimeter and centimeter. Commonly we can see in graduations. And outer end of tape may also be graduated and marked in millimeter, so as to have further more refined measurement. Now, this, looking to all this tape, we have to go to the field. We have a chain with us, we have a tape with us, chain maybe say a metric chain we are having with us, and in tape either we have a metallic tape and we have or steel tape. Now, when we go to the field, what other instrument we need to carry along with the chain and tape so that we can perform our chaining? Chaining means, again I say, that is a distance measurement. Means we have to measure the distance between two points. So let us see how what are the different instrument and how they are employed in chaining. So that is the instrument used in chaining. Now, in this, the first one probably is ranging rod. Now, let us have a quick view on the figure of the ranging rod, how it looks. Now, as the name suggests, that ranging rod, just before going to this description, I would like to give this figure, that you can see simply a rod, nothing else, but the length is 2 to 3 meter. that is the ranging rod which we can see, and it is painted alternatively white and black, or sometime white and red paint. This marking, you can see this black or red is written there. So that is the one is white, second one is black or red. So alternatively white black or white red. And why to do this? So that it could be visible from the far distance. Had it been of single color, then it will not be visible to that extent with this alternate color. Now they are used to fix some intermediate points on the survey line. We are measuring the distance continuously, and in suppose one chain is of 20 meter, but length is to be measured in the range of say 80 meter or 85 meter. So one chain is not sufficient to measure this 80 meter. So what we have to do is, we will measure one chain length, next chain length, next chain length. So that's what we fix the intermediate points, and those intermediate points would be fixed with the help of this ranging rods or poles also. So they are made of well seasoned timber, generally timber, and circular in shape or circular in cross section, with 30 mm in diameter, and common length is usually 2 meter. 2 meter is very common to be used with. Then arrow. Now they are made of 4 mm steel wires bent into hook or ring at one end and tapered at another end for easy fixing into the ground. Now arrows are employed to mark the end of chain during the chaining process. Now let me explain this, and we can also have a look on the figure exactly first, then I'll explain. This is the figure of arrow. We can see this total length is 400 mm. And while measuring the distance of line, arrow is inserted into the ground at each end to mark the chain length measured. And this helps in counting the number of chains. So what happens exactly, what arrow will do? Suppose you are measuring the distance from this two point A and B. Suppose this is the length of line which we want to measure, the distance from two point. Now let us understand with this figure. The length of line is A to B, and say this length is say 115 meter. This length is 115 meter. Then how we will measure this length? Because this length is 115 meter between A and B point, and now chain which is available to us, that is of 20 meter length. So this 20 meter will not be enough to measure all 115 meter. So what we have to do, we will elongate one chain here, this 20 meter, then another 20 meter, then another 20 meter. Likewise, we will complete the whole length. So what I do, this arrow I will mark at here, this arrow peg. So this arrow peg I will mark at every chain length. So at every chain length, this arrow is there, and then simply I count this arrow. So counting this arrows, they will give the surveyor the exact length of chain surveyed. Suppose further you have another arrow, so total six chains surveyed. So by that he would be coming to know that I have worked about six chain, the length should be in the range of 100 to 120 meter. So that is the purpose of arrow. Simply, if you, because chain would be only one, what we will have only one chain with us. This chain is to be carried here, then this chain is to be carried here, this chain is to be carried here, this chain is to be carried here, like that. So but arrow will remain in its position. So when you reach at the end, then looking previously, we will count these number, or we will count this arrow, and we will come to know total how many chains are surveyed. So that is the basic purpose This helps, that is also written here, this helps in counting the number of total chain. And pegs, now pegs are used to mark the stations. So when you start the work and when you end the work, or suppose you are measuring the distance, again I shall say that two point P and Q. So your initial station is P and final station is Q. So those P and Q would be marked with the help of pegs. Now how they look like? Pegs are simply, the figure is probably has gone, okay. The pegs are look like, they are 150 mm long, simple, the shape is like this. It will have like nothing else, and like this. Total length is 150 mm, 15 centimeter, approximately 15 centimeter, and this will have a edge, so that by applying hammer here, you can insert this into the ground, and they are wood or mild steel. So either wood or mild steel, the pegs are available, and these pegs are where they are fixed. They are fixed at starting station and end station. Means from where you are starting your work, chain work, and where you end this. So in between A and B, they would be marked, and they will mark the beginning of work or end of work. So usual length is 150 mm. The next one, the last one in this instrument used, that is a plumb bob, that is cone shaped solid material weight. It is used to transfer the point on the chain or tape down to the ground in case of measuring distance on the sloping ground. So where we will use this plumb bob, simply as the figure shows here, this is of this with one hook inside in it. So what we are doing here, suppose you are working on the sloping ground, right? So on the sloping ground, now distance generally required is the horizontal one. We never require the distance along the slope. So we require the distance horizontal one. So when we elongate a chain here, now from here to here, now where this point is to be transferred on the ground, this would be done with the help of this plumb bob. So this plumb bob would be hanged from here, and wherever it will touch here, so this would be our next point. Say you start from P, Q, then again I take another chain, next chain, again I use this plumb bob, and this would be wherever it will come to the ground, that would be R points, and so on. So this is just to transfer the points on the ground in case of sloping ground, when we do the chaining on the sloping ground. So these all are the instrument which are used while we do the surveying or while we do the chaining, and later lectures we will understand how we perform the chaining. So this is probably ends here. We understand the linear measurement, we understand the chaining, different types of chaining, and also the instruments used in chaining. Thank you very much.